Mentions, Mr. Narayan Das Gupta.
The private member bill pura khali.
I will read it, sir.
Pad dijiye.
Haan, pad raha, pad raha. Thank you very much, Vice Chairman, sir. The special mention risk exposure of banks and the economy due to NPAs. India's fifth largest private sector lender, Yes Bank, has collapsed. Shockingly, it is a loan book show a staggering growth rate in the past 5 years from rupees 55,000 crores in 2014 to 241,000 crores in 2019. Further, it has also been a big lender to bust companies like ILFS, DHFS, Jet Airways, Cox & Kings, Cafe Coffee Day, and others. Apart from loss on account of lending to already compromised clients, a serious thought must be diverted towards the various factors that have resulted in default by well-meaning corporates. MSMEs are unable to realize the position as envisioned at the time of taking loan and therefore starting to default on their loans. The problem of rising NPAs in accompanied by falling GDP, which hints at a definitive relation between health of economy and ability of businesses to pay their debts. India may be looking at a fresh cycle of NPA since loans to companies, including small and medium enterprises, may turn NPAs if cash flows of companies continue to suffer. As we are gripped by historic economic slowdown with consumption and demand slumps, banks which are already reeling under accumulated NPAs stands exposed to further default. Sadly, the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code brought in to help banks realize the money is failing the banks by causing banks to take their haircuts up to 90%. In the light of these stress factors, RBI and Finance Minister must do a risk evaluation, discuss underlying factors for default, and pursue corrective reform. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Gupta ji. Srimati Kakashan Parveen, not present. Mr. Rajamani Patil, not present. Mr. Vijay Sai Reddy, not present. Mr. P.L. Punya, not present. The House stands adjourned till 11 hours on Monday, the 16th March, 2020.